Every day in hospitals all across the U.S., medical miracles literally rescue patients from the brink of death. But in these same hospitals, millions of patients contract infection. Astoundingly, medical professionals break the number one rule of hygiene. Research shows that over half the time, doctors fail to clean their hands before treating the patient. Other professionals pull on gloves without cleaning their hands first. If you pull on the gloves without cleaning your hands first, you're simply contaminating the exterior of the gloves. So hand hygiene is the number one rule, the number one challenge. But equally important is the second challenge. That is, how to keep your hands from becoming contaminated, recontaminated, before they reach the patient. Stand in an emergency room and watch the most meticulous doctors and nurses clean their hands and glove, and then reach up and pull open the privacy curtain to see the next patient. Well, that curtain is seldom changed. It's laden with bacteria, and as a result, their hands become recontaminated just before they touch the patient. You should assume that every surface in a patient's room and in any other caregiving area is contaminated, because the research shows that at least 3/4 of these surfaces are laden with MRSA, VRE, C. diff, and other infection-causing pathogens. It's the high-touch areas that are often most contaminated.
You should assume that in addition to the patient's skin, all the surfaces in the room are contaminated with organisms that patients bring in, or healthcare workers bring into the room, such as MRSA, VRE, or C. difficile. Now, ironically, and we've shown in a large study of 36 hospitals, the areas that housekeeping focuses on to clean a room, particularly what we call terminal cleaning, when a patient leaves and another patient comes in, have been the floor, the toilet, and other traditional areas. But in reality, the most important surfaces, the ones that are truly contaminated with the VRE, the MRSA, and the other organisms that we worry about, are what we call high-touch surfaces. These are surfaces in the patient's immediate environment, like the overhead table, the rail on the bed, the call button, or the blood pressure cuff. These are all contaminated with organisms that the patients and the healthcare workers bring into the room, and you need to assume that they are all contaminated. MRSA, VRE, and C. difficile will remain alive on surfaces, even those surfaces that look clean, for days to weeks, unless those surfaces are thoroughly cleaned and disinfected. So that surface cleaning and hand hygiene are the ways we protect patients.
Tufts University researchers found that the number one strongest predictor of which patients picked up the superbug VRE is whether a patient with VRE had occupied the room in the preceding 2 weeks. That's through almost 3 terminal cleanings. So it's obvious that putting your patient in a room that's inadequately cleaned when the preceding patient was carrying VRE puts your patient at serious risk.
I'm here to look at your rash. Okay. Take a deep breath for me.
Another area of the patient's room that is seldom cleaned and therefore becomes a vector for bacteria is the infusion pump. After adjusting the controls on this item, you should definitely clean your hands before touching the patient. Lab coats can be heavily contaminated with drug-resistant bacteria. Research shows that if a physician leans over the bed of a patient who unknowingly is carrying or colonized with MRSA, 65% of the time the lab coat will pick up that germ. Then the doctor will carry the bacteria to the next patient's bed where it can be deposited. The doctor touches his coat or reaches into his pocket and contaminates his hands because the germ is on that coat. To make matters worse, these lab coats don't get laundered as often as they should. A University of Maryland study showed that 65% of medical professionals admitted that they change their lab coat less than once a week, even though they know it's contaminated. 15% admit they changed it less than once a month. A vivid example of the impact of contaminated equipment occurred in a burn unit in Galveston, Texas. When a VRE outbreak began in the burn unit, hospital personnel cultured every surface in the unit. The results were revealing. 19% of bed rails, 26% of infusion pumps, and virtually all other surfaces were contaminated with VRE. In November, a physician treating a patient with a large shoulder and neck burn noticed one item had not been cultured, the EKG wire just used on that patient. 4 days later, his patient's wound tested positive for VRE and molecular typing confirmed the germ had come from the wire. Amazing. Here's a punchline. A patient discharged 38 days earlier had left behind the VRE on that wire.